Hai guys, jadi kali ini aku mau ngobrol sama kalian tentang rencana kita untuk punya anak. Jadi sebenarnya ini sih plannya, rencananya itu udah kita rencanain dari tahun 2019. Jadi pertama kali kita ketemu dokter kita itu tahun 2019 bulan Desember ya, bulan November apa Desember gitu. Jadi dari saat itu sampai tahun ini kita tuh berharap bisa hamil secara natural ya. Tapi sampai saat ini pun kita belum hamil-hamil. Jadi beberapa bulan lalu kita bikin appointment lagi sama dokter kita, dokter kandungan. Jadi kita berbicara dengan dokternya kalau kita ini belum hamil-hamil gitu. Jadi dokterku tuh bilang tahun ini aku udah umur 40 tahun ya. Kesempatan untuk hamil itu akan terus menipis. Dan akhirnya karena sebelumnya ini kita udah membicarakan tentang bayi tabung atau IVF cycle, in vitro fertilization. Jadi mau gak mau prosesnya kita lakukan. Jadi pada bulan September, akhir bulan September, kita mulai proses bayi tabung kita. Jadi pada akhir September itu aku udah dikasih obat untuk mengkontrol ovulasi aku. Itu obatnya itu dimakan selama 10 hari. Nah setelah 10 hari obatnya habis, 3 hari kemudian aku dikasih prescription, itu injection, suntik selama 11 hari. Jadi aku udah dikasih schedule mulai suntiknya itu tanggal berapa, terus ke dokter untuk check up, untuk ambil darah, dan untuk ultrasoundnya itu kapan. Nah guys, jadi sebelum kita mulai proses IVF-nya, itu banyak forms, jadi dokumen-dokumen yang harus kita baca. Di dalam dokumen-dokumen itu dilampirkan penjelasan-penjelasan tentang resiko-resiko IVF, tentang side effects suntikan, tentang side effects pengambilan sel telur, dan side effects setelah pengambilan sel telur. Tapi setelah kita baca-baca itu dokumen, resikonya benar-benar sedikit dan benar-benar kecil. Dan juga pihak rumah sakit Stanford ini kan udah terkenal ya dengan IVF procedure-nya mereka. Jadi aku sama Gray benar-benar confident dengan dokter kita. Jadi proses-prosesnya itu setelah aku minum obat untuk mengkontrol ovulasi, aku start injections atau suntikan-suntikan. Jadi itu setiap malam aku disuntik 2 suntikan. Pertama-pertamanya sih takut gitu ya guys, ngeri gitu. Tapi setelah hari ketiga aku udah biasa, nyampurnya udah bisa, suntik sendiri pun udah bisa. Jadi selama proses IVF ini aku sama Gray akan bolak-balik dari San Diego ke Palo Alto. Untungnya anakku tinggal di ini ya, di Bay Area. Jadi selama kita pulang pergi dari San Diego ke Bay Area, kita juga jengukin atau visit anakku di sini. Nah, untuk prosesnya mungkin akan memakan waktu sekitar 2-3 bulan. Jadi tergantung dengan kondisi tubuh aku, apa tubuh aku respon ke obatnya ini cepat atau tubuh aku respon ke obatnya ini lebih lambat. Jadi kita belum tahu, jadi kita harus suntik-suntik dulu selama ini jadwalnya selama 11 hari. Setelah disuntik, nanti akan di USG, akan di ultrasound, dilihat apakah sel telurnya sudah bisa diambil. Kalau misalnya sel telurnya sudah bisa diambil, sel telurnya aku akan diambil dan disatukan dengan spermanya si Gray. Jadi pada hari yang sama, ketika sel telur aku diambil, Gray juga akan memberikan spermanya dia supaya keduanya antara sel telur dan sperma bisa digabung. Setelah itu, setelah sperma dan sel telur digabung, biasanya kita nunggu sekitar 5 hari supaya sel telur dan spermanya bisa fertilized. Jadi kalau udah fertilized, kita juga option untuk mengecek keadaan embrio. Jadi setelah terbentuk jadi embrio, itu embrionya akan dikirim ke lab yang lain untuk diperiksa tingkat kromosomnya. Jadi kita mau mastiin embrionya sehat sebelum embrionya ditransfer kembali ke rahim aku. Buat teman-teman yang baru bergabung, selamat datang. Terima kasih udah bergabung di channel kita. Salam kenal dan saya salam sehat selalu untuk kalian semua. Dan juga untuk penonton setia kita, Andika di Maluku, Ani di Taiwan, dan semua teman-teman di Indonesia. Thank you sudah nonton, thank you udah support dari jauh. Kita berdua merasa appreciative so much for you guys.
Oh yeah, other risks and side effects.
Medication to grow multiple eggs, retrieval of eggs from the ovary or ovaries, insemination of eggs with sperm, culture of any resulting.
Disorder, right? It's like multiple genes affect the, so they're working on it because it's not a single gene.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, if it's single gene, we do it, but.
Ini kayaknya obatku udah nyampe nih. You can use that box.
For what?
For your motorcycle stuff, right? Or your dad's stuff?
Maybe.
Oh, this is for the needles and syringe. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, this is why so I was concerned. Things. It's been sitting out all day.
No, it's not all day.
When did you get it?
It's like in the afternoon.
So it says to verify the contents to make sure we got the right stuff, which okay. Is probably a good idea.
Okay. Here, please open immediately. This is the... all the medicine and
okay,
stuff.
Yeah, this had the same open immediately thing on it too.
In the cartridge holder. Clean the open end of the cartridge holder with an alcohol
where
swab.
Is it? Here this.
Or maybe this one. Or is it if it's still
that's
wet.
That's wet.
Pick up the BD microfine pen needle.
Where's that?
Peel off the protective
is that
paper
this?
Seal.
No.
Do not touch the needle or place an open needle on any surface. Hold the outer needle shield.
Okay, hold on, let me just clean this.
Okay.
Wait, where's...
I said 2 inches around it.
Yeah, it's right here. So did they say, like, fast or slowly?
They didn't say either way. Well, they said if you go too slowly, it'll hurt. So they
yeah.
Not too slowly.
So remember, okay? So it's right here?
Okay. Sure. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm here, why don't you, can you wipe my fingers too, just to be safe?
Yeah.
That, my
my thumb too. Mm-hmm. Here. Okay, and then where's the gauze pad? Is that ready?
It's right there.
Oh, okay. I'll make sure it is.
Well, no hurry up before it's not. It's him.
I thought it's supposed to
like right
dry.
Here?
The alcohol is supposed to dry first. Did it?
I but wouldn't it's
blow dry. On it too yeah. much. Okay. Sure. Yeah, that's fine.
A bit right here.
Okay. Like there, right?
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Just, and I, once I put it in, I'm going to stop pinching.
Okay.
It. Okay. So just
pinch it harder.
Okay. So just stay still.
Okay.
Okay. Give me a minute.
With a sterile gauze pad. Once your injection is complete,
so I'm not pinching once I put it in, right?
Yeah, you let go just like the same as the.
Okay.
Okay, guys, ini kita mau nyuntik. Aku pakai es biar ini biar numb. Are you ready, baby? Where is the?
Yeah,
is
did you
the
clean it?
Yeah, this is the.
I don't remember.
I think so. Okay. Down a little bit. Yeah, that's where the ice is.
Okay.
Got it?
Got it.
It hurts at the end.
No.
It's okay.
Why do you think? Did I not pull it out straight, or is it just
no?
I think
no,
anyway?
No. It hurts when it, like near the end. I think because it's a lot.
So much.
Of
yeah. Okay. Mind. So now, how do I dispose of this one?
Okay. It's the same way.
Put this in here.
It the whole thing. We dispose the whole thing. Yeah. We don't need the syringe. So you need to
you
put the cap
back. You want to show me the video?
I don't think there is a video on how to dispose this one.
You do.
Thank you. Love
welcome.
You.
Just throw it in there.
Thank you. High five. Good job. I thought you'd be freaked out.
No, I'm fine.
You are fine. Ooh. Are you excited?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sorry, I'm just tired.
It's okay. Alright. We have to do this for 11 days, guys. It's okay. It's totally worth it. It's totally worth it because I'm gonna get mini you.
Little rat
cell. Okay, guys. Ini suntikan. Iya. Suntikan kedua. Jadi malam kedua nih disuntik.
Okay. You ready?
Ready? Mm-hmm.
Where do you want it? Here.
See that? See this? Like up. Yeah.
Like here, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Did it hurt?
It hurt towards the end. Mm. I need to numb my stomach still. My private nurse, personal nurse at home.
Free sponge baths.
Were you nervous when you do that or no?
Yeah. I can only tell you now because I didn't want to tell you the first time because I knew you'd freak out.
I was a little freaked out. But now that I see that you're actually doing it really well, makes me feel better. I love you. Thank you, baby.
Love you.
Teamwork. Jarumnya besar. Jarum is needle.
No. Let's be
sad. Not too big.
No.
The other one is bigger. This one is like...
So like here in the middle there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Selesai. No.
No, okay.
Just good. A little tiny bit. I forgot I can feel it.
What?
Like that, the pain a little bit. Mm-hmm. It's okay. Sorry. There's no needle down there, right?
Right, no.
Okay.
No, that's here in the other one.
Oh, jadi habis disuntik itu sakit perutnya, guys. Sakit ini aja sih, abis suntikannya aja yang sakit. Tapi setelah itu udah nggak terasa. Dikompres pakai es dulu. Jadi ini kan 6 kaku wilayah yang di area yang dikasih es itu jadi kaku, jadi dingin. Jadi waktu jarumnya masuk itu nggak kerasa. Doain ya guys ya, semoga berhasil.